Hey, mate, is there people in there?
I heard sound like
tools and something. I can hear.
Someone's screaming.
No, I could hear like...
The latest from this scene is our fire crews are now working on making the building as safe as we can. We've got some issues with the dividing wall. It's been moving during our operations, so we're scared of it actually falling down onto the firefighters. So we're looking to establish how we can make that safe. We've got a structural engineer on the way. We've also found asbestos in the building, so we're cordoning off the area and creating exclusion zone to prevent anybody from being contaminated by that asbestos. Currently we still have two people missing inside the building. We're using thermal imaging cameras and a line and hail search to try and establish if there's anybody still left in there, and we've not heard from anybody. We do have grave concerns for those people within the building. We've got our canine detection dog also on the way with our fire investigation team, and we'll be using those to scour the area and determine what may or may not have caused the explosion. Following that, following the exclusion of all of those things, we'll attempt to find anybody within the building and recover any bodies if that's the case.
This was far from a normal building fire, wasn't it?
Well, certainly we've had an explosion during the fire. We're not sure whether the explosion was the cause of the fire or was caused by the fire, and those facts will come out during the investigation throughout today. Yeah, we do. We've confirmed we've got two people still in the building. That was confirmed by the two people who we rescued from the building. They're telling us there's two more in there, and that's what we're currently doing, and searching for those two people within the building.
Can you tell us how this all unfolded? Like the two men, were they all together?
Hey,
are we up next? Or
how were they rescued?
They weren't. On arrival, the building had essentially been exploded. And we found two people in the rubble on the ground floor. The other two people were not sighted, were not able to be found. Our crews then tried to search the building to establish if there was anybody in there. We had some New South Wales police officers also on scene. Seven of those officers have been treated for smoke inhalation at this time. But unfortunately, we only found those two people who were in the rubble, on the upper layers of that rubble. The other two people are yet to be found. Yeah, our understanding is that there was a lot of people obviously heard that explosion and came out to investigate and did a lot of good work to try and get people away from the building and to ensure that nobody else was affected by the smoke or any falling debris.
Do we know what sort of business it was?
My understanding is we haven't got any civilian injuries. We've only got the seven police officers who were injured and overcome by smoke. The premises, we understand, was a $2 shop. On the ground floor, and a residence for four people on the upper floors.
And sorry, but the police officers, they suffered smoke inhalation trying to rescue those men?
The police officers suffered smoke inhalation being in and around the fire and trying to rescue those men who were there.
And this person was trapped under that rubble.
My understanding is he's quite lucky. He's got burns, cuts and bruises, but he's in a stable condition. So his actual status I'm not sure about, but he's certainly not life-threatening. No, they were both in the rubble at the time, and they were removed by firefighters with the assistance of the police in the early stages of the fire.
Paul, can we say at this stage on what level of the building the four people who were inside were on? Were they in the $2 shop on the ground floor or the residence on the first floor?
We believe they were in the residence on the first floor, and as the building collapsed, they collapsed with it.
So quite an extraordinary experience. Two people very, very lucky to be alive today.
Indeed, two people are extremely lucky, and how they've got out of there I think will be the discussion for quite a while. Very lucky for those two people, but unfortunately we've still got two people trapped in that building.
Were they on the same part of the room or the floor, or are they in different rooms?
They were essentially within 20 feet of each other.
So they're four men, are they? Four men?
Well, we understand that that's the case, but we're not totally sure of the sex of those two people that are still missing, and that's yet to be confirmed.
Can you
the kids inside? No, there's been no reports of children.
Can you just describe the intensity of the fire?
When firefighters arrived, as I said, the building was partially collapsed and continuing to collapse. All the windows had been blown out and the doors had been blown out, and there was fire exiting from all of those areas. So it was a very, very intense fire when the firefighters first turned up. They attempted to enter the building to search for people, but the flames and heat was such that they fought the fire from the outside.
Any telltale signs on what caused the explosion? Is it likely to have been a gas explosion or some other form of accelerant has been used, perhaps?
Look, there's no indications exactly what's caused the explosion, and that'll be the subject of investigations throughout the day. As I said, our canine detection dog will be here, and she should be able to rule out the presence of accelerants. And from that, we'll continue our investigations throughout the day.
How many people did you have to get out of the Wentworthville Hotel?
All those people self-evacuated, and we weren't part of the evacuation there. The New South Wales Police were around and doing ensuring that everybody was away from the area while the fire brigade did their job.
Do you know if the men are related to one another?
No, we've got no indications of who they are, what their status is, or what their relationship is. No. It's a very, very dangerous operation. As I said, that building weighs many, many tons, and it has been moving throughout all our operations. We've got crews watching it intently. Their job is to simply watch that wall to make sure it's not moving. We're only putting minimal crews in there at this point in time. And we've got structural engineers on the way who will give us an indication of exactly if it does fall, which way it will go, and what will happen. But that being the case, we are still anxious to find the two people in there, and we'll continue working until we do so.
Great. Thanks so much.
In total, the New South Wales Ambulance transported 10 patients, all in a stable condition at this stage.
That's a pretty full-on morning for you guys, 10 transports.
It has been. We've coped extremely well under the circumstances. All patients, fortunately, at this stage, all stable.
So several of them were police officers?
Most of them were police officers, correct.
And I understood there were two other men, or were there three, are you saying? A total of 10?
A total of 10. 8 police and two citizens.
Now, the two gentlemen who were actually in the building at the time of the collapse, what are their injuries?
At this stage, mostly smoke inhalation and minor burns.
So they've been very, very lucky to escape the explosion and blaze without more serious injuries?
They have been extremely, extremely lucky to get out of this one. As you know, the building is completely demolished, as well as the fire inside the building. So they've been extremely lucky. New South Wales Ambulance prepare their staff for such emergencies. And I congratulate all the staff that was here today, transporting fellow colleagues from other agencies. And yes, it can be confronting at times, but staff are very well prepared for this. And we'll definitely do a debrief after the event.
Oh, look, I live about 2 km away. There was a loud bang. Then there was successive, what sounded like gunfire, but successive multiples, you know, multiple sort of explosions. But there was, it was pretty big, pretty intense. There was people living upstairs in the hotel, right opposite the building. The windows blew in over the top of their beds. Lucky they had curtains, which sort of shielded them from the glass.
Yeah. It's one hell of a bang.
Very, very big bang. As I say, if your fence was rattled 2 km away, that's a mighty big bang.
Trying to get somebody out. Thank you.